So good morning class 8 students. We have come to an end of your chapter 6 combustion and flame. Today I will discuss the last topic of this chapter, which is related to environmental pollution due to combustion of substances. So whenever carbon containing fuels are burnt in air, they produce different polluting gases like carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, etc. Of all these pollutants in the air, most common is the smoke produced due to this burning. Now these pollutants in the air cause many diseases in the human body and different types of symptoms, reactions in the body. Here is a table showing the different air pollutants and their effects in our body. You see, dust is very common, dust and smoke. Dust and smoke are the major pollutants for respiratory system. They cause respiratory blockage and asthma-like diseases. So whenever there is burning of fuels, say in case of metro cities, people suffer from different allergic reactions and respiratory problems due to heavy rate of burning of these fuels, especially in the vehicles, heavy vehicles, automobiles and the chimneys of the factories. Next, there are carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide gases produced due to domestic fuels or from the vehicles, cause respiratory problems, and due to the blockage, heavy blockage or severe blockage of the respiratory system, it may lead to death even. Carbon dioxide is known as the greenhouse gas, one of the most significant greenhouse gas on Earth, which is responsible for increasing the temperature on the Earth's surface. Next, oxides of sulfur, because sulfur is also one of the components in the fuels of the vehicles. Oxides of sulfur like sulfur dioxide, sulfur trioxide, can damage lungs as well as produce acid rain and cause corrosion of the materials on Earth. Now in the previous classes you have read about acid rain and greenhouse gas as well. Greenhouse effects, you have a basic idea about it. So acid rain is actually the mixture of the acid which is present or which is falling on the Earth's surface along with the rainwater. Therefore, carbon dioxide, which produces carbonic acid while reacting with water molecules, and sulfur oxides of sulfur produces sulfuric acid while reacting with water. Therefore, these acids fall on the Earth's surface along with rainwater. Oxides of nitrogen, nitric oxide, nitrogen dioxide, etc., can cause congestion of lungs, and they also produce smoke. It is a mixture of smoke and fog. So mostly in the metro cities we find during the morning time or in the afternoon time, the air becomes quite foggy or smoggy, you can say. Because of this high rate of air pollution along with dust and smoke in the air. Therefore, burning or combustion of fossil fuels have direct effect on the human health. The harmful gases produced due to this combustion can cause many types of lung diseases as well as irritation in the eyes and sometimes even skin diseases. As we are talking about acid rain is the rainwater containing dissolved oxides of nitrogen and sulfur. I repeat, acid rain is the rainwater containing dissolved oxides of nitrogen, that is nitric oxide, nitrogen dioxide, and oxides of sulfur. This type of rain is very harmful to both living and non-livings. Let us see what are the harmful effects of acid rain. It is highly acidic and corrosive in nature, that is, damage the different metallic surfaces. It promotes corrosion of the metallic structures. Acid rain reacts with limestone and marble stones. As you know, limestones, marble stones, these are used for the constructions of different sculptures in the ancient times, in historical times. So now such stones of historical monuments are corroded due to acid rain, because acid rain reacts with those stones and they finally lose their shine. So that is one of the significant effects of acid rain on our earth, that different historical monuments and sculptures get corroded and lose their shine due to reaction with acid rain. Acid rain also affects plants and marine life, certainly. Also, it can decrease or reduce the fertility of soil. Due to continuous acid rain in an area, or say every year in an area, can cause loss of soil fertility of that area. So as you can see, acid rain is highly damaging on the earth surface. Therefore, we must take care about this such type of things so that we can reduce the production of or the occurrence of such type of acid rain. Now I am going to discuss about greenhouse effect, one of the most interesting and important factor on earth. Literally, greenhouse effect means the rise in temperature that earth experiences because of certain gases in the atmosphere can trap the sunlight energy. Without these gases, heat would have escaped back into space and Earth's average temperature would be about 60 degrees Fahrenheit colder. Because these gases warm our world, so they are referred to as greenhouse gases. Now, what is a greenhouse? Or to be precise, glass house. A greenhouse is actually a glass house in the hilly areas. So students, your today's homework is to draw this and draw color and label the diagram properly. In this diagram, the arrowheads show how solar radiation passes through the clear atmosphere, how some solar radiation is reflected back and all, So please draw and color this. We will discuss this concept in the next class.